Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Biochemistry of Cell. In that we are studying topic working of an enzyme. What if I say that for a particular substrate there is only one enzyme present, and if that substrate is not there, that enzyme won't work. This is how enzymes function. Enzymes. In chemistry lab, we all have used certain chemicals, and these chemicals in chemistry labs are used to fasten up the reaction process or to get the end product. For example, when you do titration without phenolphthalein, that titration result or the pink color change won't come. Similarly, when you do acid-base reactions, pH change is dependent upon NaOH as well as phenolphthalein indicator. Similarly, inside our systems, there are certain chemicals which are present, which are called as enzymes. Enzymes are nothing but catalysts that help us to speed the reactions inside our body. Now, there are various enzymes present inside our body. It could be pepsin, trypsin, hormones, insulin, and every enzyme in our body has different function to do. And each and every enzyme works in a certain fashion and on a certain parameters. Now, enzymes are basically made up of proteins, or you can say amino acids. They help to catalyze a specific chemical reaction depending upon their nature and the place where they are working. For example, insulin secreted by beta cells of the pancreas will act on glucose and help us to form energy from glucose. Without the presence of insulin, glucose cannot be used. So basically, insulin and glucose are like lock and key. It is a lock and key model. That is why we say for a particular substrate, that is glucose, there is only one particular enzyme, which is insulin. Insulin is a hormone. Now basically, enzymes could be anything. They can be hormones, they can be digestive proteins like pepsin, trypsin, or they can be growth hormones. Enzymes could be anything in your body that help us to speed up a chemical reaction. Now, in a reaction, substrate binds to the enzyme at an active site, and substrate participates in the reaction by binding to the enzyme on the active site, and after the chemical reaction, what is formed is called as product. Now, formation of these products takes place at certain steps. So let us see what enzymes are. Enzymes, they are protein molecules capable of catalyzing specific chemical reaction. When I say catalyzing, it means speeding up the reaction. Basically, majority of the enzymes are proteinaceous in nature, or they are made up of amino acids, small building blocks of proteins. Enzymes are termed as biocatalyst. Bio means biology, and catalyst means a biomolecule that helps us to speed up chemical reactions in biochemical system, which could be a human system. Enzymes participate in reaction by combining with substrate. An example of an enzyme would be trypsin. enzymes. Okay, enzymes speed up the reaction process. Working of enzyme is enzymes basically function as lock and key model. For example, for a particular lock, there is one key. Similarly, for a particular substrate, there is only one enzyme present, or there is a family of enzymes that is present. Enzymes work in a certain manner. An enzyme has an active site, and to this active site, a substrate will bind. When a substrate binds to the enzyme on its active site, it forms ES complex or enzyme substrate complex. Now, this enzyme substrate complex will react in a certain manner and it will form product. Now, once the product is formed, this product cannot fit the active site of an enzyme, and hence this product is removed out. It goes to the place where it has to be used, and the enzyme along with its active site come back to its original position, and then the reaction will start once again. You can see in this reaction that enzyme is not changing its shape, as well as the active site of an enzyme remains intact. This is the reason why enzymes are needed in small quantities. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied the working of an enzyme and how active site of an enzyme remains intact during the chemical reaction. I hope you all have understood the working of an enzyme clearly. Thank you.